Hi, I'm Sam Eckel, Technical Application Manager for Generac Clean Energy, and I'm back with PWRcell Pro Tips. Today's topic is troubleshooting a PWRcell inverter in state standby, waiting, or low rebus voltage. The inverter may remain in state standby, waiting, or low rebus voltage if it cannot fully connect to the AC grid. This can happen when voltage or frequency from the grid is outside of the parameters established by the selected grid profile. The default profile parameters follow IEEE 1547 for voltage and frequency. The default range for voltage is 110 volts to 126 volts line to neutral, and the default range for frequency is 59.5 hertz to 60.1 hertz. New inverter firmware will enforce the enter service delay of 5 minutes upon commissioning the inverter for the first time, and any time the inverter loses its grid connection thereafter.
Firmware versions greater than 13.853 will display state waiting during the 5 minute enter service delay, while older firmware versions may display state standby or low rebus voltage during the same 5 minute delay. Note, firmware version 13.853 will display rebus under voltage events alternating with event pattern lockout during the 5 minute enter service delay. The inverter is technically in a waiting state while these events occur.
If the inverter cannot connect to the grid, you will see standby, waiting, or low rebus voltage displayed in PowerFleet and locally on the inverter screen. Additionally, the homeowner may notice they have no production from their system in their PWRview mobile app. To troubleshoot, first determine whether the status of standby, waiting, or low rebus voltage is expected behavior by answering the following questions. Have you just commissioned the system for the first time, or has there been a utility grid outage? If either of these are true, confirm whether the inverter has completed its 5 minute enter service delay. If standby, waiting, or low rebus voltage persists beyond the 5 minute enter service delay, there are 4 reasons why the AC grid may be outside of the specified range for the inverter to interconnect. Number 1, there may be a loose or corroded connection on line 1, line 2, or neutral somewhere on the AC side. Number 2, there may be a blown fuse in your AC disconnect if equipped so that one phase has an open circuit. Number 3, the same phase may be landed on both line 1 and line 2 terminals at the inverter. Number 4, there may be an issue with the quality of service from the utility. In all cases, the first place to start is with your multimeter. Before you begin with your meter, be sure to access the installer configuration tool to confirm whether the inverter is programmed to the proper grid profile for your utility jurisdiction. Then confirm the line voltages measured are within the parameters for that profile. This can be verified by confirming against the rules for interconnection with the utility or by downloading a copy of the compliance report from the installer configuration tool. Note, split phase inverters must have true 240 volt split phase power. Installation of a split phase unit on 2 legs of 3 phase service, sometimes referred to as single phase 208, will result in perpetual standby, waiting, or low rebus voltage. Now let's dive in on the first reason why the inverter may not be able to connect. Start by measuring voltage at the AC grid connection terminals of the inverter. Be sure to measure line 1 to neutral, line 2 to neutral, and line to line. Again, the default range for voltage is 110 volts to 126 volts line to neutral, and you should see nominal voltage of 240 volts line to line. If voltage is drastically low or non-existent when measuring line to neutral or line to line, you likely have a faulty connection. Inspect for solid connections at the inverter AC grid connection terminals. Ensure you have a solid connection at the 40 amp AC breaker for the inverter's interconnection, and ensure that breaker is in the on position. Likewise, check for corroded connections, loose neutral connections, or a poor connection with an inner piercing connector for a supply side tap. Reason number 2 has to do with your fused AC disconnect if equipped. If you're using a fused AC disconnect on the inverter circuit for interconnection, ensure the fuses have continuity and are fully seated. Then ensure the disconnect is closed in the on position. Reason number 3. Don't measure nominal voltage of 240 volts line to line at the AC grid connection terminals of the inverter, and instead you measure 0 volts. Inspect whether older existing service equipment may have led you to land the same phase twice. If AC voltage measurements check out, change your selector to measure frequency. Verify the frequency of the AC connection at the inverter falls within the default range to enter service, 59.5 hertz to 60.1 hertz. And lastly, number four, if voltage or frequency are out of spec and you cannot determine the root cause after thorough inspection, contact your foreman and discuss next steps. You may want to install a power quality meter on the service temporarily, or you may need to contact the utility and have them inspect the electrical service to the home. Other temporary solutions to try on site may include turning on load in the home to lower grid voltage so that the inverter can connect, or disabling other inverter systems that may be operating on site. If you're still having issues, contact Generac Clean Energy Technical Support. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on PWRcell Pro Tips.